If we want to find out the normal and shear stresses at failure, so for that mainly triaxial test is conducted. And so using this test we can find out the stresses at failure. Apart from this, direct shear test can also be used. So using these tests we can find out the stresses at failure. And next thing we want to know is the failure plane. So to find out the failure plane, we use Mohr-Coulomb failure criterion. And so before going further into that, we'll see the principal stresses in brief. So let's say there is this soil mass, and this stress here indicates the stress condition at this point in the soil mass. So sigma 1 is the major principal stress, and sigma 3 here is the minor principal stress. So in case of soil, compressive stresses are considered as positive. And in a stress element, shear stress, if shear stress is such that it produces anti-clockwise couple at center, it is considered as positive. So there is this difference between strength of materials, and here it is the opposite of that. So if we want to find out the stresses, that is normal stress and shear stress, at a plane which is making theta angle from the major principal plane. So here this plane is the major principal plane, and this plane here is making theta angle from this major principal plane. So we want to find out the stresses. So for that we can use this formula, that is sigma is equal to sigma 1 plus sigma 3 upon 2 plus sigma 1 minus sigma 3 upon 2 cos 2 theta, and tau is equal to sigma 1 minus sigma 3 upon 2 sin 2 theta. Here sigma 1 is a major principal stress and sigma 3 is a minor principal stress. And same things, the same stresses can be obtained using the Mohr circle also. So this every point on this Mohr circle will indicate a plane on this point, passing through this point. So we can find out the stresses on all the planes. It means if we have plotted the Mohr circle, that means that we are representing all the planes that pass through this point, and we can find out the stresses through all the planes. So using these two formula also, they are valid for Mohr circle also. So using these formula we can find out the normal and shear stresses. And now let's see what did Mohr say about this Mohr failure criterion. So he said that the shear stress on the failure plane at failure is a function of normal stresses on that plane at failure. So he said that the shear stress is a direct function of this normal stress. So what we can do, or what he suggested, is that we do several tests or several triaxial tests at different major and minor stresses. So let's say first this is the minor principal stress and this is the major principal stress. So for that value we got the Mohr circle like this. And if we change these values, so first sigma 1 was something 1 and sigma 3 was 0.5, and then we do 2 here or something here, so then we'll get some other value. And similarly we can get n numbers of Mohr circles. Now if we draw a tangent such that it touches all these circles, so that curve, it will go something like this. So this curve here, it is called as Mohr failure envelope. So what does it show? That at any point in the soil mass, if stresses are such that if we plot the Mohr circle for that stress, and if that Mohr circle lies below this Mohr failure envelope, then for that stress condition, shear strength is greater than shear stress. That means failure will not happen. But if stress is such that this Mohr circle goes above the Mohr envelope, so here in this area some planes will lie at which shear strength is less than shear stress. That means shear stress is more, so failure will happen. इट मीन्स दैट देयर कैन नॉट बी एनी सर्कल विच क्रॉसेज दिस मोर फेलियर एनवलप. सो दैट्स वॉट मोर सेड. एंड आफ्टर दैट देर इज कूलम हाइपोथिसिस. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू कूलम इट्स शेयर स्ट्रेंथ डिनोटेड विथ पी. सो शेयर स्ट्रेंथ इज गिवन एज सी प्लस सिग्मा टेन फाइव. हियर सी एंड फाइव आर द शेयर स्ट्रेंथ पैरामीटर्स. सी इज द कोहेशन एंड फाइव इज द एंगल ऑफ इंटरनल फ्रिक्शन. So this equation is also equation of straight line. If we plot the straight line between this sigma and this P, that is shear stress, I mean shear strength and this normal stress. So for that it will be a line something like this, and this angle here is phi. So and this intercept will be equal to C. So according to Mohr, if we combine these two theories, that is Mohr Coulomb hypothesis, so this is the line which is showing the shear strength. So it is similar to this Mohr envelope, but Mohr envelope is a curved line, or it is a curve, but this here it is taken as a straight line. So here we can say that at that any Mohr circle which lies below this line or this line of shear strength, so for that failure will not occur. But if a circle, Mohr circle, is such that it just touches this shear strength line or this envelope, so for that failure is imminent, it is just about to happen. So from there we can find out the what is going to be the plane. So here I have shown the same, this is this line, that is C plus sigma tan phi. So C is the intercept and phi is the angle here. So this is the point of failure. So at this point failure will happen. So for this point we can say from this triangle, so this is O A B, so here this angle is theta, so and this angle here is 90 degree, that is the between radius and the tangent. So 90 plus phi is equal to 2 theta. So from here we can say that theta is equal to 45 plus phi by 2, and that is the angle of plane at which failure will happen. So this is the plane at which failure will happen, and this is the plane angle of that plane. So here it comes out to be 45 plus pi by 2, and we can show this with the same thing with some other analysis also. So what happens here, the difference in shear stress and shear strength is minimum at the point of failure. So this is not the point of maximum stress, because maximum stress we know it will happen somewhere here, that is the point of maximum shear stress. So maximum shear stress, it is given as sigma 1 minus sigma 3 upon 2, that is the radius of this circle. But at this point the shear strength, because of this line, shear strength is here and shear stress is here. So at this point shear strength is more, but at this point the shear strength is just equal to the shear stress. So at this point failure will happen, and this point is called as the point of maximum obliquity. So the for maximum obliquity condition is tau upon sigma should be maximum. So that we'll see. So first let's see how can we say that the difference between shear stress and shear strength. So shear stress, as we said, shear stress is given as sigma 1 minus sigma 3 upon 2 sine 2 theta, and shear strength, if I'm denoting it with P, and it is given as C plus sigma tan phi, and sigma here is equal to sigma 1 plus sigma 3 upon 2 plus sigma 1 minus sigma 3 upon 2 cos 2 theta. If we put it here and we take the difference, so let's say x is the difference between shear strength and shear stress, that is P minus tau. So it will be equal to C plus sigma, if we put here, that is sigma 1 plus sigma 3 upon 2 plus sigma 1 minus sigma 3 upon 2 cos 2 theta minus sigma 1 minus sigma 3 upon 2 sine 2 theta. So this difference should be minimum. So for this difference to be minimum, dx by d theta should be equal to 0. So if we do the dx by d theta, so here it is tan phi also. So here remaining will be, this will be 0, this will be 0. So here remaining will be minus sigma 1 minus sigma 3 upon 2 sine 2 theta into 2 into tan phi, and minus sigma 1 minus sigma 3 upon 2 cos 2 phi, 2 theta, not phi. And so from here, if you put this equal to 0, so this 2 will cancel out, and this 2 will also cancel out. So from here, tan 2 theta minus tan, or I can say minus tan 2 theta is equal to cot phi. And so minus tan 2 theta, we can write this cot phi as 10 minus 10 90 plus 5. So from here 2 theta is equal to 90 plus 5, and theta is equal to 45 plus 5 by 2. So which is the angle of failure plane. So from here also we can say that at the point of failure, the difference between shear strength and shear stress is minimum. Now one more relation is obtained using this condition. Let's see that. So in this triangle again, OAB, if I want to write sine phi, so here sine phi is equal to, this is 90 degree, it means this is the hypotenuse, and so sine phi will be perpendicular by hypotenuse. So perpendicular is the radius. Radius is equal to sigma 1 minus sigma 3 upon 2 divided by this part will be, so this length here is the sigma 1 plus sigma 3 upon 2 comma 0, and this part here will be C cot phi. So this total distance will be sigma 1 plus sigma 3 upon 2 plus C cot phi, and if we multiply it there, so sigma 1 plus sigma 3 upon 2 sine phi is equal to C cos phi, it is equal to sigma 1 minus sigma 3 upon 2. So if we multiply this 2 there, so sigma 1 plus sigma 3 sine phi is equal to plus 2c cos phi is equal to sigma 1 minus sigma 3. And if we just divide it, multiply the sine phi inside, so sigma 1 sine phi, and here also there is sigma 1, so if we take it on this side, so here it will be equal to sigma 1 1 minus sine phi, and similarly if we bring this on this side, sigma 3, here it will be sigma 3 1 plus sine phi, and this is 2c cos phi. So from here sigma 1 is equal to 1 plus sine phi upon 1 minus sine phi into sigma 3 plus 2c cos phi upon 1 plus sin phi. Sorry, 1 minus sin phi it will be. 1 minus sin phi. So here this we can write it as this. It is like this plus 2c cos phi we can write equal to 1 minus sin square phi. That's under root 1 minus sin square phi. And this we can write here under root of 1 minus sin square phi. This 1 plus sin phi upon 1 minus sin phi. Sigma 3 it is here 1 minus sin phi. So this we can break in parts, that is 2c 1 minus sin phi into under root 1 plus sin phi, and here it is 1 minus sin phi. So this will cancel out here, so it will remain 1 minus sin phi here. So sigma 1 is equal to now 1 plus sin phi, 1 minus sin phi sigma 3 plus 2c under root of 1 plus sin phi upon 1 minus sin phi. 1 plus sin phi upon 1 minus sin phi can also be written as tan square 45 plus pi by 2 plus 2c. This will be tan 45 plus pi by 2. So this is another relationship which will be very useful in not only in this unit but in other units also. So here tan square 45 plus pi by 2, it is also denoted with n phi. So if we put it here, so sigma 1 is equal to sigma 3 n phi plus 2c under root of n phi. We can represent it by like this also. And if we are talking about pure cohesionless soil, so for that C is equal to 0. So from here we can say that sigma 1 is equal to sigma 3 and it was 1 plus sin phi upon 1 minus sin phi. So from here sigma 1 upon sigma 3 is equal to 1 plus sin phi upon 1 minus sin phi. And this is another relationship. And sin phi, if we rearrange these things here, so sin phi here will come out sigma 1 minus sigma 3 upon sigma 1 plus sigma 3. That is one more relationship. So the last thing that is remaining is the plane of maximum obliquity. So plane of maximum obliquity, as I said earlier also, it is the plane of where this ratio tau upon sigma is maximum. So tau is given as sigma 1 minus sigma 3 upon 2 sine 2 theta, and sigma is given as sigma 1 plus sigma 3 upon 2 plus sigma 1 minus sigma 3 upon 2 cos 2 theta. And so for this value to be maximum, let's say it is denoted with y. So for this to be maximum, dy by d theta should be 0. And if you try to solve this, so from here also you will get theta is equal to 45 plus pi by 2. And that was the plane of failure. So from here we can say that the failure occurs at plane of maximum obliquity and not on the plane of maximum shear stress. So we saw that on the plane of maximum shear stress, shear strength is more. So if it is something like this, here as I showed, here it is the point of maximum shear stress. So at this point, shear strength is here. So shear strength is more than shear stress. So the failure does not occur at the point of maximum shear stress. It occurs at the point of maximum obliquity, where this ratio is maximum. So this is it for this video. Next, we'll see in the next time.